This video will be showing you how to download ebooks from OverDrive to the type of Nook eReader that is unable to download the Libby or OverDrive app. If you are using a device that can download the app, please see our video on how to download Libby. For the type of devices I'm talking to you about today, you will need to have a computer and a USB cable to connect your device to your computer. You will also need your Rochester Public Library card and your library password that you can create on the Rochester Public Library website, which is rpl.lib.nh.us. If you have forgotten your password or need assistance setting this up, please email us at rplreference@rochesternh.net. Before you begin downloading ebooks to your Nook, you will first need to download Adobe Digital Editions. To do that, open your browser. Search for Adobe Digital Editions. Choose the one that the web address says www.adobe.com. Click on Download. If you have a Mac, choose the first option. If you have a Windows, choose a second. Windows is what I have, so that's what I'm going to choose. When I click that, it downloads down here. It shows up right down here on my bar. Now that is if you're using Google Chrome. It might look slightly different if you're using a different browser. Once I have that installed, I will be back. Once that has installed, you will now need to authorize your computer under Help. Go to Authorize Computer. And you will need an Adobe ID. If you do not already have one, click on Create an Adobe ID. It'll open a window and you'll fill out this information. I already have one, so I'm just going to log in. Now that we've authorized the computer, we can now go and download a book. Open your browser again and go to newhampshire.overdrive.com. Sign in. Select your library, choose Rochester Public Library, enter your card number, and when it asks for a PIN, you will want to enter in that library password that you created on the Rochester Library's website. Now that you're logged in, you'll see this screen again. You'll see my account here, which will take you to your loans, things that you've placed on hold, your wish list, if you've rated any titles. You'll also be able to see the history of items you've checked out in your settings. You can search here if you know a title that you'd like to find. You can also go over here under subjects, which is one of my favorite ways of looking for books. Click on that. With the format that we will want is ebooks. Now I'm going to choose the category Mystery. If we want to check out something today, you will want to make sure you see only things that are available. For instance, these items have a wait list, so you wouldn't be able to check those out today. So over here on the left, click on Available Now, and you will see a whole list of things that you could check out right away. So let's check out this book. When you click on it, you can see a description of the title down below. Right here is where you would click borrow when you're ready to check it out. So let's do that. You can choose to borrow for 7 days or 14 days. Once you've decided, click borrow. It'll tell you here when you have it checked out until. If you have space to check out more items, you'll see that here. You can read it right in your browser, right on your computer, or we can download it so that we can transfer it to our Nook. So on your computer, go to your downloads. On my screen, I can see it right down here. Click on that, and it should open in Adobe Digital Editions. Once it's ready and downloaded, you should see the title here. But to get it to your device, you'll click on Library. Go to the Library view. You will find the book that you borrowed. For me, it was this Murder in the Manor. So that's the title you'll want to transfer. Connect your Nook to your computer. You'll connect it using your USB cord from the device to the computer. For the title that you want to transfer to your Nook, click and make sure only the one is selected. Click and drag to your Nook where it says it under devices to the left. When you see a plus sign, let go and it'll copy to your device. And now you're ready to begin reading your book.